Hello students, today I am going to teach you Reach for the Top lesson from unit 8. So open the page number 99. See, this is the part 1 of our story Reach for the Top. This is the story of a Santosh Yadav. Santosh Yadav is the first woman in the world who climbed the Mount Everest. That is the highest peak of the world, you know. For the not only first time, for the second time, for the twice. She climbed that Mount Everest for the twice. And first she climbed on May 1992. After that, next year in 1993. So, two years back to back, she climbed the Mount Everest, which is the very proud moment or very toughest, I must say, toughest thing to do. But she did that for the two times. So, let's see what is the, how she did that. What's her family, what the struggle she faced, what's the efforts she did to become like this. So, I am starting for the before you read. Think for a while and make a list of 3 to 5 persons you idolize or admire very much for their achievements. Your idols may be from any sphere of life, sports, medicine, media, or art and culture. So this is the thing, this for you, you have to think like who the person you admire, you make them your inspiration, your idol for your life, for your achievements. So just think about that. Who is the that person who inspires you to become something? So he can be a sport person, or he can be any actor, or he can be any politician, or he can be from any media. But you should have one idol, so that by seeing or by watching them, you will grow up. Your teacher will then discuss your choices with you to find out who the top 5 idols of your class are. So this is the for you. Now, starting from the story. The only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing, and a daughter, though not considered a curse. Curse means in Hindi you can say shrap. So this is the girl who climbed the Mount Everest for the twice. But in her family, the birth of a girl, baby girl, is not, they are not like excitement. They do welcome the boys like greater than the girl. So see, when they are finding the birth of a boy, then it is the blessing. But if there is a girl, it is not like any sharp, any curse, but they are not to welcome that much. Was not generally welcome. So the girl child is not welcome. When her mother was expecting Santosh, a traveling holy man. Holy man means saint, any Baba, Sadhu Baba, giving her his blessings, assumed that she wanted a son. Means when the Santosh mother was expecting, means when she was pregnant and she was traveling, and one Sadhu Baba just bless her that she will get a baby boy. But she denied that. She never said, I want a girl or I want a boy. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. But the grandmother of that son, means you can say the Santosh mother's mother or maybe mother-in-law, said, "No, we don't want a baby boy. We don't want a son." So it was a very surprise for them. The holy man was also surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessings, and as the destiny would have it, so he, holy man also, that son, that Sadhu Baba also got surprised, but he just gave the blessing, and after that the Santosh had come. It means the baby girl has come in their family. The blessing seemed to work. Santosh was born the sixth child in a family with five sons. It means they have already five sons in that family, so that it is not, they were not expecting for a son again, maybe. A sister to five brothers. So he have five brothers and plus she, Santosh, they were six. She was born in the small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. So she was born in Haryana, which is in which there is a village, Joniawas, in Rewari district. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. Contentment means satisfaction. Santosh means what? Satisfaction. So that is why just that girl have that name Santosh. But Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. But it seems like Santosh is not Santosh in his life by wearing the traditional wears, by or acting like a traditional. She is not. She was totally opposite of that traditional look. She began living life on her own terms from the start. Where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. So when in that time all the girls were wearing traditional, but the Santosh was totally opposite, against of that. She was wearing shorts like jeans or anything western. Looking back, she says, "Now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and a rational path, the others around me had to change, not me." So this is the most, you can see, line she all the time say, that if I am not doing anything wrong, then not, so it will be like, see, she is very determined, she is very firm that what she want to become or what is she doing in his in her life. So she is just saying, if I know, I am a very rational, I am a very normal human being who knows right and wrong thing. So if I am doing anything correct, then all the other who thinks that I am wrong, so they have to change their opinion, not me. I will not change my opinion or my state of living. I will do what I like. Because she was that much mature that she know what is she doing. She will never let down her parents. She will always became them proud. So that she was very firm, very determined that she, whatever she is doing, that is right, that is not wrong. So she is saying that if I am doing anything wrong, then they should change their opinion. I am not. Santosh's parents were affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best school, even to the country's capital, New Delhi. which was quite close by. So it means they were very healthy and wealthy. So there was no any shortage of money they have. So they can afford to send Santosh to New Delhi, which is the capital of India, which is very nearby the Haryana. So they can afford that. They can send her to the for the education. But in line with the prevailing custom in the family, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. But custom is all the traditional. Line with means following or in accordance with or according to means all the girls were following or all the villagers were following that girl should be do or take education in village only, so that she also need to follow that. So she just got the education or learn in her local village only. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived. But she know that she is so small now, so she cannot fight. So just she was waiting for the right moment that she will fight against this also. And the right moment came when she turned 16. Now she is 16 years old. So now she is thinking it is the right time to say, because she wants to learn. She was very firm, very determined that what she wants to do, what she wants to become. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. So in their village on that time, ancient time, all the peoples were following that trend. What was that? When the girl is 16 years old, she needs to get married. But that is why Santosh was also in under pressure that she also need to do the same. Her marriage as early as that was the last thing. Last thing means the least important thing on her mind. It means she wants to do lots of another things, and marriage is all the at the very last stage. She wants to do another more things. After that she will get married. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. Threatened means you can say disclaimer or chetavani. She just threatened her parents that if you will not give me the proper education what I want, then I will not get married. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. And after that, she was now 16 or maybe 17 years old. So that she was enough mature. So she left the home for the education. So she herself enrolled her admission in the Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. When her parents were very angry that how she can left the house, how she can went in another city. So they were very angry on her. But she was very firm, she was very polite, so she don't get any emotional. She just politely answered them, okay, don't pay my fees, I will work, I will do part-time job and I will pay at my own self to the school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education, but by listening all this, her parents get ready to pay for her school fees. Wishing always to study a bit more, and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed the higher school examination and went to Jaipur. Then day by day she was wishing, she was desiring to take more education एंड आफ्टर दैट शी वेंट टू द जयपुर ऑल्सो टू पास द हाई स्कूल एजुकेशन. शी जॉइंड महारानी कॉलेज एंड गॉट अ रूम इन अ कस्तूरबा हॉस्टेल एंड इन दैट इन द जयपुर द महारानी शी जस्ट गेट एडमिशन इन महारानी कॉलेज एंड नियर बाय देयर वर कस्तूरबा हॉस्टेल एंड शी गेट एडमिशन देयर ऑल्सो. संतोष रिमेंबर्स कस्तूरबा हॉस्टेल फेस्ड द अरावली हिल्स. आई यूज टू वॉच विलेजर्स फ्रॉम माई रूम गोइंग अप द हिल एंड सडनली वैनिशिंग आफ्टर अ व्हाइल. देन फ्रॉम द रूम विंडो शी ऑल द टाइम वॉचिंग दैट द अरावली हिल्स वेन द पीपल आर गोइंग देयर ऑन दैट हिल बट आफ्टर सम टाइम दे गेट वैनिश. वैनिश मीन्स डिसअपीयर. So where they gone? That is the surprising questions to her. One day I decided to check it out myself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. I asked if I could join them. Then one day she decided to check that what happened on that Aravalli hills. So on one day she went there and she just asked the mountaineers that it is possible or if she can, it is good if she can join them. To my pleasant surprise, the answer in the affirmative and motivated me to take a climbing. But affirmative means in positive way. So they were the people were like very good people. So they just not only told her that yes, you should climb, but they also motivate her that yes, you should do this. Then there was no looking back for this. No looking back means if you are going, you are progressing something, then there is no need to take back. Determined young girl, she saved money and enrolled in a course at Utkarsh's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. Now after that she just got very motivated. She was very excited to do that again, and that is why she is now taking the education of mountaineering also. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April but ended on the 9th of May. And I was supposed to be there in Uttarakashi on the 21st. So see, her college is going to end on 9th May. But after that, again her mountaineering will start on 21st May. So there was only 6 days difference. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. I had to write a letter of apology to my father, without whose permission I had got myself enrolled at a Utkarshi. So there was only 6 days difference. So she decided to not go to the home in this vacation. And again, she wrote a letter to his father, apology letter, that without his permission, she got the admission in the Utkarshi college. So see, in this you can see she was not only firm, but she was very polite. She was very she never disobeyed. She disobeyed her parents, and if she is doing anything against that, then she is again taking the apology also for that. Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly, means developed. She was very you can see she was very firm that what she wants to become, and that is why she was growing very rapidly, very fastly. Also she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. See, resistance means the ability not to be affected by something. And altitude means height. She now used to, she get used to with the, that height and that the coldness which is on the top of the mountain, but she got very used to that. So there was no any difficulty she is facing for climbing the mountain. Equipped with an iron will, physical endurance and an amazing mental toughness, she proved herself repeatedly. The culmination of her hard work and the sincerity came in 1992. See, culmination means end. Now she was doing the hard work from so much time, but finally in 1992 she got her result. Just 4 years after, she had shyly asked the Arnavali mountaineers if she could join them. So just after 4 years she got her result that she became one of the first women in the world who climbed the Mount Everest. At barely 20 years of age, Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. So she was very young. 20 years means nothing. It is just for us, it is just a start of our growth, start of our, you can see, any new education or any new, it was very startup for us. But at that age, she was first woman, youngest woman who climbed the Mount Everest. If her climbing skills, physical fitness and mental strength impressed her seniors, her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the heart of her fellow climbers. So she have lots of strength, not only physically but also mentally. She have that mentally and physically strength, and that is why she was there, right? And because of her that strength, all the not only juniors but also seniors also got very affected, very attached with her, and that's why they also like to climb with her. During the 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Pole. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. So on 1992, what happened? When she was climbing, there was one person who was dying there. But she did her best, but she could not do more, so that he get died. However, she managed to save another climber, Mohan Singh, who would have met with the same fate, means on that destiny, had she not shared her oxygen with him. So, but on the same path, she got another person, Mohan Singh, and she saved his life. Within 12 months, Santosh found herself a member of an Indo-Nepalese women's expedition that invited her to join them. So within 12 months, she got another chance. She then scaled the Everest at a second time, thus setting a record as the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice and securing for herself and India a unique place in the annals of mountaineering. Means historic record. She made a historic record that a woman who climbed the Mount Everest for the twice. In recognition of her achievements, the Indian government bestowed upon her one of the nation's top honors. Top honors means highest award in the Padma Shri. So because of this achievement, she got Padma Shri award, which is the top of the awards. She got that Padma Shri also. Describing her feelings when she was literally on top of the world, Santosh was said, "It took some time for the enormity of the moment to sink in. So, see, enormity means a very great moment. So when, see, sink means what to be understood. When she was climbing on that Mount Everest, she did not get anything. But when she is on the top of the mountain, then she feel that beautiful, that was the very beautiful feeling she was feeling. And that is why she is saying that it is the very great moment for her. Then I unfold. Unfold means unfold the Indian tricolor and held it aloft on the roof of the world, means on the high peak of the mountain. Then she unfold our tricolor. Our tricolor means our jhanda, tiranga, and then she took that on the very highest of the top of the mountain. The feeling is indescribable. She cannot describe that feeling. The Indian flag was flying on top of the world. It was truly a spiritual moment. I felt proud as an Indian. And that moment was very proud of her. She was not making only her parents proud. She is making her all the world, all the nation proud. And she cannot forget that. Also a fervent. Fervent means having a strong and sincere feeling. Environmentalist Santosh collected and brought down 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. So when she was getting down, she was very connected to the nature. She liked to do the for the nature. She was environmentalist, and that is why she took all the garbage, which was 500 kilogram, which was a half kg. She took that garbage of Himalayas. So see, this is the very inspiration for us actually. In day-to-day life, we all the time we can see there is the garbage in our surrounding. But what we do, we are also doing the same thing. But this Santosh is taking the garbage of Himalayas, of all the mountains. So this is the very, I must say, very touchy story for us, that it is not about the climbing the mountain, but if you are doing these small things by taking the social responsibilities at our own self, that then we will do lots of things to our nation. So I hope you understand this story. This was a very sensible and very inspirational story. You must read this story and just think what you can do for the nation or for your parents. So we will meet in next video in part 2. Thank you.